Hello students, this is Dr. Sangeeta Joshi from Vidyalankar Institute of Technology, Mumbai. Course is Basics of VLSI Design. Module 5, Data Path Design. Today we'll learn barrel shifter. Introduction. A barrel shifter is a digital circuit which is used to shift a data word by a specified number of bits in one clock cycle. It has a control input which actually specifies the number of bits by which we would like to shift the data. Shifting operations are widely used for arithmetic shifting, logical shifting, as well as rotation operation. A common usage of barrel shifter is in hardware implementation of floating point arithmetic. It is also used for scaling and multiplications by a constant number, as well as data alignment and in address generation. Design of a shifter is basically a trade-off between area and delay. Barrel shifter is a wire-dominated circuit, and hence area is basically dominated by this wiring. It is appropriate for small type of shifters. Types of shifting operations. There are three types: logical shift, arithmetic shift, and rotate. Now, in case of logical shift, it shifts either towards left or right and fills with the zeros. For example, logical shift right by one bit position, and this is the number 1011. Now, you are shifting towards the right. That means this one will be moving out least significant position, and then this 101 would be shifting towards the right. So 101 is shifted here and 0 is filled in here. Similarly here, shifting towards the left. So this one most significant bit would be discarded and this 011 would be shifted towards the left. So here is the 011 and 0 is filled in here. Now, in case of arithmetic shift, sign is extended. Okay. Now, arithmetic shift right towards the 1 bit. 1011. You are shifting towards the right. That means this least significant bit would be taken out and this 101 is shifted. So, this 101 is shifted right. But this is filled with the sign of the number, and this most significant bit is the sign bit. So this same sign bit is reflecting here as the most significant bit. Now you are shifting this in this case towards the left, and here 011, this one is moved out and this 011 is shifted, and now here the 0 is inserted. Now in case of rotate operation, we are shifting left and right, and it fills with the lost bits. What does it mean? That means, for example, rotate right by one position. Now 1011, you are rotating it towards the right, shifting towards the right. So this least significant bit will be moved and this will be taken as the most significant bit. So, because this would be the vacant place, whenever you are shifting towards the right, most significant would be the vacant place. So, here 101 is shifting. So, 101 is shifted and this least significant bit is taken as the 1. And similarly, here it is the left operation. So, you are actually moving the most significant bit and then that would become the least significant bit. So, this one is taken out and that is then placed at the least significant. So, the number would be 0, 1, 1 and 1. Programmable binary shifter. So this is a 2-bit word A0, AI and AI minus 1, and the output is BI and BI minus 1, and these are the pass transistors used for this shifter hardware implementation, and there are three operations: right, no operation and left. And this table describes the entire functionality of this circuit. Now, for example, whenever you do not want to have any operation, that means the number has to be reflected AI and AI minus 1 as the same at the position BI and BI minus 1. That means this whenever the first row, no operation, whenever the NOP is 1. Now let us look at the operation of the circuit. Now whenever this NOP is activated, this pass transistor is turned on as well as this pass transistor is turned on. Now the moment you turn on this transistor, the data from the this place, that is AI data, would be transferred through this transistor to the BI position, and AI minus 1 would be transferred to the BI minus 1. So you are getting the same number at the output. So here you will find the A1, A0, and the same A1, A0 would be appearing at the BI and BI minus 1. Now let us look at the write operation. So whenever write is activated, that means the second row, it is the green color row, here you will find that you are shifting A1, A0 towards the right. That means A0's place would be taken by A1 and 0 would be inserted here. So you are getting finally at the BI and BI minus 1, you will be getting 0, A1. Now let us look at the operation. Now whenever you are activating this write signal, so this pass transistor as well as this pass transistor would be turned on. Now whenever you are turning on this transistor, this 0 would be transferred to the BI, and that is how your BI, you are getting the 0. Similarly, whenever this transistor is turned on and this input which is connected to the AI would be transferred through this pass transistor to the BI minus 1, and therefore you are getting here the BI minus 1 as nothing but the A1. Similarly, whenever it is the left operation, whenever the left operation is there, so here this transistor would be turned on as well as the this transistor would be turned on, and then the data from this position AI minus 1 would be transferred through this transistor to the BI, and this 0 would be transferred to the BI minus 1. So here you are at the BI minus 1, you are getting the 0, and at the A0 you are getting, at the BI you are getting the A0. So basically these are the select signals, and this is acting as a multiplexer. So one of the inputs would be taken at the output based on the select signal. Let us understand the function of 4 bit by 4 bit barrel shifter circuit, how it works. Here the input is A0, A1, A2, A3, 4 bit word. Output is B0, B1, B2, B3, and control signals are shift 0, shift 1, shift 2 and shift 3. Now since it is 4 bit shifting and input word is 4 bit, we are calling it as a 4 bit by 4 bit barrel shifter. Now in this table, you will find the summary of shifting operation. Whenever, and these control signals are mutually exclusive, meaning that at a time only one control signal would be activated. Now whenever, if shift 0 is equal to 1, what does it mean? That means A0, A1, A2, A3 would be appearing as a B0, B1, B2, B3 as it is. That means there is not any shift operation. Shift 1, whenever it is equal to 1, meaning that we are shifting the input word by 1 bit position towards left. So that this A1, this is the original position. So this A1 becomes shifted to the A0's position towards 1 bit left. So A2 is shifted here, A3 is shifted here, and the A3's vacant position, it is actually filled up by the A3 only. In shift 2, whenever it is active, we are shifting the original word by the 2 bit position. So that A2, it was here, now it is shifting 2 bit positions and it becomes the here. So your B0, B1, B2, B3 becomes the A2, A3, A3, A3. And whenever you are shifting towards the left by 3 bit positions, this A3 becomes the most significant bit, and rest of the bits are filled with the A3. Now let us understand how this barrel shifter circuit can be implemented with the help of the pass transistor logic. Now this is the 4 by 4 grid we are putting. So there are 16 squares, and in each of this square we are putting a pass transistor, right? Now how many rows are there? There are 4 rows. And how many columns? There are 4 columns. These are the 4 columns. Now how do we decide that? It is based on the number of bits in a word, input word. So what is the word length? Here the word length is A0, A1, A2, A3. These are the 4 bit numbers, and therefore we are having the 4 rows. And number of columns, how many are there? There are 4 columns. And how do we decide? That is based on the maximum shift width. Now here maximum shift width is the 4 bit positions. Shift 0 is no operation, and shift 1, shift 2 and shift 3. So therefore we are having the 4 columns. Shift 0, shift 1, shift 2 and shift 3. Now let us put pass transistor, NMOS transistor in each of these squares. Okay. Now you look at this table. Whenever it is shift 0, now you can see here, actually ideally it is diagonally. I have put all the control signals to each of these pass transistor as a shift 0. We actually, since we are shifting towards the left, we should come from top to the bottom. So basically what is happening, basically here in case of shift 0, my A3 becomes B3, my A2 becomes B2, A1 becomes B1 and A0 becomes B0. And therefore I am putting the here A3 is the input to this pass transistor, output is the B3. So A2 becomes B2 here, A1 becomes B1 and A0 becomes the B0, and control signal is the shift 0, and this yellow color I have given to all these shift 0 positions. Now let us look at the second row. What is the second row? It is the shift 1. So I have started from this. Actually what is happening here? Here I want A1 to become the B0. So actually this is my B0 row. These are the outputs B0, B1, B2, B3 I am getting. So what do I want? I want A1 to be the B0. Okay. So I am writing here the A1, that to be the B0. And then I want A2 to become the B1. So I am writing here A2 to become the B1. A3 to become the B2. So these three are in this diagonal, and now what I want? I want the A3 to become the B3. So the next position is here, because we are shifting. So next position is this position. So A3 becomes the B3. And in the shift 2 operation, I want A2 to become the B0. So this is the shift 2 operation. So A2 to become B0, A3 to become B1. And then rest of the 2 bits are here. A3 to become B2 and A3 to become the B3. So that is the A3 to become the B3. And in the last operation, A3 to become B0. So this is the shift 3. So A3 to become the B0. That is the first A3 to become the B0. Then A3 to B1, A3 to B2 and A3 to B3. So you can find here A3 to B1, A3 to B2. And A3 to B3. So what we have done, we have arranged the NMOS in pass transistors in such a way that these operations would be possible. Now actually in the subsequent diagram we would be connecting all the shift 0 signals. So all shift 0 signals will be connecting, then all shift 2 we will be connecting, all shift 1 also we would be connecting, and shift 2 also we would be connecting in a diagonal fashion. And then all B3s also would be connected. Now you can see here, these all B3s are there. Here is B3, here is B3, here is. So I will be connecting all these B3 and making one line and taking this as output. All B2s, here is the B2, 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 B2. So all these B2s would be connected and taken at the output. All B1s would be taken at the output, and all B0s also would be connected and taken at the output. And similarly for the A0, A1, A2 and A3, all A0s, A1s and A2s and A3s we are connecting. Let us continue 4 bead by 4 bead barrel shifter. As I told you in the earlier slide, we are supposed to connect all the shift 0s, all the shift 1s and shift 2s and shift 3s. Similarly, all the B0s, B1s, B2s and B3s. So, we have made slight modifications in the earlier diagram. We have placed the position of the pass transistors in such a way that the connections would be easy. Now, so we are connecting this. We have seen that diagonally shifting up, this was the shift 0 line. So, all these shift 0s are connected together. You can see here. So, this is the shift 0. And then this is the shift 3. All these control signals going to the gate of these transistors are the shift 3. This shift 2s are connected and shift 1 is here. Similarly, here shift 1, these control signals are connected together and this shift 2 control signals are connected and this is the shift 3. Similarly, all B0s are connected and taken out. So, here it was the B0 because we had seen here that A0 has to become the B0. So, this B0, this B0, this B0, all these B0s are connected together and taken out and these are the four buffers. So, B0, B1, B2 and B3 and here all the B1s are connected together. So, this is B1, this is B1, this is B1, this is B1, they are taken out. Similarly, here the B2s are connected and they are taken out. Similarly, here the these B3s are connected and they are taken out. Now, you can look at the A0, A1, A2 and A3 signals. Now, here you can see it is connected to the A0, whereas these three pass transistors are connected to the A3 transistor. You can see here A3 line, sorry. This is the A3 line. So, this is connected, this is connected, this is connected. Now, here you will find that these two are connected to the A3 and these two are connected, these two transistors are connected to the A1. And here you will find this is the A2 line, isn't it? This brown color is the A2 line. So, that is connected to this transistor as well as the this transistor. And this is all these 1, 2, 3 and 4, all these last column pass transistors, they are connected to the A3 line. Here you will find that this purple color is the control wire and this red color or brown color is the data wire. So, this is the data A0, A1, A2, A3, these are the data wires and this shift lines, these are the control wires. Let us now verify this truth table or the functional table. Here you will find that whenever shift 0 is activated, if whenever shift 0 is 1, so, whenever this is 1, entire this line would be 1 and you will find that this transistor, all these 4 transistors would be turned on. And actually what we are expecting at the output, A0 becomes B0, A1 becomes B1, A2 becomes B2 and A3 becomes B3. Let us now check. Now, whenever this transistor is turned on, this is connected to the A0. So, that will be passed to this and then that will be output at the B0. So, A0 becomes the B0. Now, whenever this transistor is turned on, so that time now this is connected to the A1. This is the A1. So, A1 is connected to the, this is the output is the, it is connected to the B1. Whenever this transistor is turned on, because of the shift 0 is equal to 1, so this input is connected to the A2 line. This is the A2 line and then it passes through this transistor and then the data would be the B2. So, B2 becomes the, A2 becomes the B2 and finally this last transistor, whenever this is turned on, this line is connected to the A3. So, A3 becomes the B3. So, this first row is verified. Now, let us look at the shift 1. Whenever shift 1 is equal to 1, basically what we are expecting, A1 becomes the B0. Let us verify that. Now, whenever shift 1 is 1, that time this control, so get to this control transistor is 1, get to this transistor is 1 and get to this transistor is 1. So, all these three transistors would be turned on. Similarly, shift 1 is 1. So, this transistor also would be turned on. Now, whenever shift 1 is equal to 1, so this is this line which is connected to the A1 this A1 data would become the B0, and that is what is written here. A1 becomes the B0, A2 becomes the B1. Now whenever this is turned on, this is connected to the A2, so that A2 becomes the B1, and whenever this is turned on, which is connected to the A3, so A3 becomes the B2. And similarly, whenever this is turned on, this is connected to the A3 and that becomes the B3. So A3 becomes B2 as well as A3 becomes the B3. So likewise, you will also observe for the shift 2. Let us again take one more example, shift 2. Now whenever this line is activated or it is selected, so that time both of these transistors as well as shift 2 means both of these transistors would be turned on. Now what does it mean? That means this data which is connected to the A2. So A2 becomes the B0. You can see here this A2 becomes the B0. Whenever this is turned on, this is connected to the A3. So A3 becomes the B1. So here A3 becomes the B1. Similarly, whenever this shift 2 is 1, so this is connected to the A3. So A3 becomes the B2. So A3 becomes the B2. And then finally A3 becomes the B3. So actually this is the shift 2 is 1, so it is connected to the A3, so A3 becomes the B3. So likewise, you can also work it out for the shift 3, so wherein you will get the all A3s at the output. So this is the functioning of the barrel shifter, 4 bit by 4 bit barrel shifter. Now whenever you want to convert this circuit using, or whenever you want to build this circuit using the transmission gates, so that time what you will do, these are the NMOS transistors. So we will place a PMOS transistor here, and that gate would be connected to the shift 1 bar, because this is the shift 1 signal. So that would be the opposite signal. So that would be the shift 1 bar. So similarly here shift 2 bar, here shift 3 bar, and here shift 3 bar, here shift 0 bar. Okay. So we can also have this circuit using the transmission gates. Digital Integrated Circuits, A Design Perspective by Jan B. Rabe. This is the book I am using as a reference book for this presentation. Thank you, students.